Good morning. Part of our bug watch modules in the Watershed Access Lab is to teach you how to sample aquatic invertebrates in flowing river situations. So Kim and I are going to show you the basic technique for sampling aquatic insects, two in fast moving water and two in slow moving water. We'll just do the fast moving water this morning. You need a number 30 mesh net or 500 micron net, and we put that into the stream to capture the insects that are going to be dug up on the bottom. Kim's going to use these gloves and a brush to dig up the insects on the bottom so that they flow into the net. So when you grab a stone off the bottom, you need to brush it with like a vegetable brush. That'll help dislodge any insects that have webs or cases built on the stones so that they flow into the net. We want to sample an area about a half a meter in front of the net, but not directly in front of the edge of the net, so we minimize the amount of sand and rocks going into the net. It's important to use gloves in these situations because you don't know if there's broken glass or metal or fish hooks in the stream. So we want to be sure that you're safe doing this kind of sampling. The waders are helpful. Some people use wading sandals, but the gloves are really essential, and the vegetable brush is really very helpful in getting the insects off the stones. So when we're done digging the stones and brushing them with the brush, then we either use our boot and disturb the bottom, and that current will dislodge the insects into the net, or we'll use the gloves themselves and dig into the bottom to dig into the sand and gravel a little bit to get any insects that are living in the bottom. Then once that's done, I take the net and move it up through the current to get the material that's been collected in the net. And what we want to do is wash that sample to get any fine sand out of it, and we'll put it into this sampling bucket. So I'll wash the sample. And then take this accumulated material that we're going to put into the sampling bucket. We typically do this for two fast water samples and two slow water samples. Then we wash the sample and put it into our labeled sample jar, which we'll do now. So we'll show you washing this sample. We'll come to the shore to do that. We like to wash the sample so we can get any stones or gravel separated from the insects and leaves. And so we swirl it to dislodge the insects that are in the debris collected off the bottom. And we'll pour that through a number 30 mesh screen to trap the finest insects, but allow the water to go through. And we'll pour it through the number 30 mesh. Fast enough to get the debris out, but slow enough to get the rocks and the sand in the bottom of the bucket. Then I inspect the sample, make sure we've got all the insects removed. Once we're satisfied with that, we'll take this sample and put it into our labeled sample jar. So Kim's already pre-labeled this jar, and it's 70% ethanol that we preserve the insects in the jar. So you do four samples and put all of them combined into one jar, and that would be your sample for this site. In case there's any insects stuck to the screen, we'll use a pair of forceps to pick them out, make sure that they're put in the sample. Okay, so what we'll do next is show you the clip on how to subsample this and pick out the insects for study in your class.